Hi friends, I am SM Zakir Hussain with a surprisingly good news. Today, we're going to see that calculus is really very easy. No concept of limit or slope will be required. Even those who don't have mathematics background can easily learn calculus. The method is so simple and interesting that we don't need any introduction at all. Those who've heard of calculus know that it's the mathematics of change, rate of change. To begin with, let's take a function, fx equals x, x itself. Well, now suppose that the variable x represents a line segment. And the function also represents the same line segment because the variable and the function is the same thing. Now suppose that the line segment is increased by a small amount. It's clear that the function also will increase by the same amount. Well, let's think in terms of numbers. Let's assign consecutive values to x, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. You can easily see that when the value of x is 1, the value of the function is also 1. And when the value of x is 2, the value of the function is 2. In other words, the value of the function moves with the value of the variable. So, what this clarifies in this context is that the change in x and the change in the function is the same thing. According to the established rules of calculus, here's the formula for the derivative. That is, d by dx x to the n equals n x to the n minus 1. Here, n indicates the power of the variable. And the function of x means the function of x to the 1. So by using the Newtonian method, we get 1 as the derivative of x to the 1. Here, 1 indicates that there is change, but the change is constant. Well, here is the simple calculation. Well, now let's take another function, a squared function, x squared. In this case, whatever the value of x is, the value of the function is a squared quantity. Now let's represent our function with a geometric figure, the square that you can see here. Obviously, each of the sides of the square represents the variable x, and the area represents the function. We'll call it a field with two dimensions, length and width. You might call it height as well. Now let's do a thought experiment. Let's imagine that a pressure is being created inside the field so that the field expands. However, we'll go back and start from the beginning in a new way. We'd like to see the increase in one dimension at a time. So for the time being, let's see how the field increases vertically, that is, upward. This is the total vertical increase. We've increased the height only by 1 unit. And the base or width remains the same as before. Because x multiplied by 1 equals x, we only have x as a total increase in this dimension. And it's to be noted that we don't have the power 2 with x. Now let's see how the change happens horizontally. This time too, the length is increased only by 1 unit, horizontally. But the width is same as before, that is, x. So the total increase is x times 1 equals x. Now look at the whole thing once again. We'll see how the change happens in both directions simultaneously. As you've already seen, this is the increase in each side. And the total increase shows that the derivative is 2x. X plus x equals 2x. And why is that? That's because this is the total change in the field for a unit change in x. You see that this is why the power of the derivative is less by 1 than the power of the function. As is obvious from this demonstration, the Newtonian method also produces the same results. Note that you might think about extending the field in these directions, downward and to the left. However, that will only lead to duplicate calculations. Field extensions can only happen in the dimensions it has. In the present field, we only have 2 dimensions. So, let's once again summarize the main points. Now let's take a cubic function, a function with 3 dimensions, function of x equals x cubed. It can be represented by the cube, the geometric object. And here it is. This time too, let a pressure be created inside it, so the field is expanded upward only by 1 unit. Because we've changed the height only by 1 unit, the other 2 sides will remain constant as before. So the base on which the change happens is x times x equals x squared. And the amount of increase is base times 1 equals x squared. The same change will take place in the other 2 dimensions. The total increase will be number of dimensions times change per dimension. Here the number of dimensions is 3 and change per dimension is x squared. So the total change will be 3x squared. And we see that the Newtonian method also says the same thing. And according to our new method, the total change is number of dimensions multiplied by change in 1 dimension, which ultimately produces the same Newtonian formula. Now, here is the summary of the new approach to calculus. Suppose that you have a function, x to the n. Imagine that the function represents a geometric field with n dimensions. So that when 1 dimension is increased by 1 unit, the other dimensions will remain unchanged. The field comprising these other dimensions may be called the base. Thus, if the function is x cubed, then the base is x squared. That is, break down the function into 2 factors, one of them being x. For example, if the function is x cubed, then we'll have x squared times x. Here x squared is the base and x is the factor for which we'll use the value of 1 to show unit change.